Hello and welcome to another video from the Greatest Trout on YouTube, and finally is episode 1 of my FIFA 15 career mode on next gen, my first series on next gen, Xbox One by the way. And let's just say we're diving straight into this. If you're wondering why I've just randomly started on the first game of the season and haven't done any transfers or pre-season, basically I set up a thread on the EA forums on the section, the community stories section. I'll put a link in the description. So basically on there I've put kind of the pre-season stuff, build up to the season. And that'll kind of be where all the other stuff apart from the matches goes on. As you can see, I'm doing a Burnley career mode on Legendary. It was my first game as Chelsea, so this is going to be interesting. I am taking the role of Sean Dyche and the Ginger Mourinho, and I did not win a game in pre-season. As I said, the results are on the EA Forum's community stories, which is in the description, the link. But anyway, I think we're going to do this first game on Legendary. I'm going to keep saying that a lot, especially if I win. This is a team we've gone for based on the pre-season stuff. Keane basically got put in there after his performance in the last friendly, where he scored an absolute screamer against Augsburg. Sordell was very promising in the Real Sociedad game in the friendly, and Ings obviously scored a lot of goals in the championship. I think his reward surely should be starting in this game. Then we've got Arfield and Keightley. You know a lot of these from the Premier League in the first couple of games. It was close between Heaton and Gilkes, but I just had to give it to Heaton in the end. Trippier obviously in there as well. He's going to be a dangerous player. 6 minutes. Craig Pawson as a referee. And here we go. And that was pretty slow, but I thought it was going to freeze there. I did have a lot of problems with freezing on the last game, so that was a bit of a worry for a second. But yeah, I don't know how I'm going to be able to cope doing commentary and playing Chelsea at the same time on Legendary, but we'll see. Anyway, we're coming out, and look at that, Turf Moor on the game. Unbelievable. Who would have thought it a year ago? Who would have thought that Turf Moor would be on FIFA? Sadly, for some reason, it isn't on the Monday night. They seem to have just put everything on the same day. We may have actually forgot to put the thingies on. There's Diego Costa. We're going to have to man-mark him like crazy. This video might go a bit longer since I'm kind of showing all the presentational stuff, even though you've probably already seen it yourselves. But here we go. We're going to go defensive. Well, Schwartz is in goal. That's a bit of a weird choice. They're clearly underestimating us here because they haven't even put Courtois in goal or Cech. Wow. Anyway, here's Schürrle, who does another interesting player starting. Mikel, so that, uh-oh, here's Oscar. Oh. Well, there's me saying it's a weak side, which it is, but they've just gone and scored against us anyway. That's not a great start. Not even Fabregas is playing. No Matic. And Oscar has scored, was in 3 minutes. Why can't I do that for me on fantasy football? Sean Dyche will be livid. Obviously not replicating real life. Oh my God. Got to send Costa off. He's giving me yellow though, which is pretty crazy. Straight in the book for Costa. Hopefully we can maybe get him sent off now. Maybe rile him up a bit. Although he doesn't seem to be able to get sent off. I mean, he should have been sent off at the weekend when he did the whole thing with Zabaleta, but amazingly he didn't, as we tried to sneak in the back door there, but we couldn't quite. And here comes Oscar again, who looks like he could be a dangerous player with Costa's layoffs and whatnot, kind of taking the Lampard role. Here's Keightley. I also got a bit of sore throat, which is probably the worst possible timing for a sore throat, but it has happened. And Costa has been absolutely murdered by one of my defenders there. I think it was Keane rushed out to him. wiped him out slightly as Arfield's gone down there, which has left space for Willian, and he's found Ramirez. It's not a bad ball in. Oh, they've hit the bar, and the keeper was just a passenger there. And, oh God, I thought there was going to be someone over there. This has been a disastrous start so far. 12 minutes in, we've barely had a touch of the ball. Chelsea are all over us. This is exactly what I envisioned probably happening. We have played about... Uh-oh, here comes Oscar. No, he's messed it up. Thank God for that. Here's Sordell. Ings. There's no way through there. Got to adapt to this. We have played 6 games in total on this new game, and this is the first night of me playing on it, so there's no wonder I'm struggling. Oh, my God. It's 2-0. It's Oscar again. Well, I did lose 5-0 with Barcelona to Chelsea on the demo on Legendary. It looks like we could have a repeat here, but I really haven't been struggling too much with this game. Obviously, I said that I didn't win a game in pre-season. I didn't, but I was relatively in the games. Oh, dear. That's pretty horrendous. Oh, giving away a free kick. Well, this just is not going well at all. I think there's no way back into this unless we can pull a miracle. I think a goal will be successful. If we can keep it at 2-0, it'll probably be good. Oscar. Oscar's just running the show at the moment. Mugged him off there, though. Here comes Arfield, and now we've got a bit of space to break. And here's a chance, maybe. Arfield running down the wing. There's no one coming over to tackle him. Here comes Zuma. It's not a bad ball. Danny Ings couldn't quite get there. It's a chance again. Oh, that was a bit weird. He just kind of went down. I don't know if that was kind of a dive. Oh, that's been given away, though. And here's a chance again. Can Arfield whip it in? He can. Marvin Sordell, he's headed it. Oh, what a goal! Marvin Sordell! It's creeped over Schwarzer and it's 2-1. And Turf Moor is rocketing. Oh! I did not think that was going in. That is the loopiest header I have ever seen in my life. And, well, hope has been restored. 2-1. Who knows what could happen now? Chelsea were sleeping there at the back. And Sordell, who scored a brilliant goal for me against Real Sociedad, capitalises. Well, that's added some enthusiasm to this. I thought I was going to be commentating with a sore throat about depression for about 20 minutes. But instead we've got a chance now. And here's a chance to counter as well. And all of a sudden, the game's in our ascendancy here. We're really starting to control this game. Here comes Ings. We're really finding a lot of success down that right-hand side as well. Actually, we've got a free kick. I didn't even realise that. But Schwarzer looks a bit nervous now. I have no idea why he started him out of all of them. And all, that's a chance. And Michael Keane, this is similar range. Oh, I thought he was going to do what he did in the friendly again. He's made a good tackle there. And it's Sordell, Arfield again. Felipe Luis is having a bit of trouble adapting to the Premier League. And it's a chance here. And it's a hit. Oh, it's wide. We maybe could have took a touch there. That might have worked better for us, but hit it wide. But anyway, we are starting to bring chances together. I think, kind of like you would expect with teams getting promoted in real life, we kind of had to get used to the Premier League. And now I think we have. I say that. Well, I thought they might have scored after I said that, but they didn't in the end. Oh dear, that's not where I wanted to go. I wanted to go to Jones, but that didn't happen. Here comes Ramirez. Oscar again causing me problems, but Keane does brilliantly well. And here's a chance for Sordell, maybe. Oh, couldn't quite clip it past. I think it was Terry. But Sordell is looking bright. Well, Ings has been there and around, but obviously Sordell got the goal, and he's been probably looking like the best player in pre-season and this game. I've had a lot of experience with him, though, as well. I did a Charlton career on the last game, and he did quite well for me there. And here comes Keane again. The centre-back, I was trying to clip it inside to Ings there. That was never happening, though. Maybe Keane needs to get back now. He's maybe going forward a bit too much. Arfield into Keane again. He just wants the ball left, right and centre. Here's Arfield into Chalobah, the youngster. Here's a chance to Sordell again. Similar range, and this time he tests Schwarzer but it's headed low that time, but it was an easy save in the end. Costa really hasn't had much of a touch of the ball despite Chelsea scoring two goals. Here's Ings. Oh, he's done very well there in Ings, and he's hit it. Oh, it's straight at the Schwarzer in the end, but we really are starting to form some chances now. We're starting to actually dominate the game, but we just can't find a second goal. That might be our undoing in the end, if they can get another one. Here comes Oscar, which is not good for us. Here's Mikel. Schürrle. Oh, God, here comes Costa. Just got to herd him out there. It's gone back to Ivanovic. Costa. Mikel. That's trouble. Oh, he's put it in again, and it's Oscar again. I do not believe this. Well, it's just a simple pass in the end, and he's just got there ahead, and it's a hat-trick in one half for Oscar. Why can't he do that on fantasy football for me? Dear me. Here's Jones into our field. If we can get another goal back, maybe there'll be a bit more hope, but that's another deflating goal, really. Here's Ings, maybe. He couldn't quite keep it in. It's just really frustrating that we're really starting to get back in the game there. It looked like, I don't know what was going on there with Felipe Luis. It looked like we're getting back into the game, possibly even looking for an equaliser. And then that goes and happens, and that's half time. So yeah, I think our poor start and our poor defending has really cost us. Manchester United won, Swansea won. There's a lot of draws in there. West Brom winning. Liverpool also only drawing. So for some reason all the games are on the Saturday. I don't know quite why. Here's Keane anyway. Hopefully maybe we can get another goal back. Start to test Chelsea a bit in the defensive area. Here's Arfield. Oh, this time Felipe Luis gets the best of him, which is exactly what we didn't need. But it's ridiculous that Costa just has barely been involved in this game, yet they've scored a hat-trick, Chelsea. I don't know why Oscar has been so good, but he's absolutely ripped me to shreds. Here's Ivanovic anyway. Willian's completely done me. quite literally there. Here's Sordell. This is a chance to counter, maybe. And it's... No, he hasn't got the pace. That's the problem with this team as well. There's not as much pace. That's where Sordell helps me. He's got a lot of pace, and he can get into the box and attack quite well. A lot of the other players just don't have enough pace. And here's Oscar again, and it's touched away by Shackle in the end for a corner. It's going to be Schürrle that whips it in, I think. We're trying to get a block in there, but again, Cahill's done well. If we can maybe hit them on the counter here, if we can nab the ball off them. But here's Cahill. Tried to win it off him there, but couldn't quite. And Schürrle's put a great ball in there, but it's headed away. And it's back to Ramirez. We've got to make sure it doesn't go to four, otherwise it might start getting embarrassing. 3-1 is respectable because it is a real-life score. Here's a chance for me to break. Sordell. Ings. And he's found Arfield, and Willian is tracking back. He's probably a lot quicker than Arfield, which isn't going to help us, and it hasn't. Arfield just doesn't have quite enough pace. Here's Jones. No. Oh, quite frustrating. Couldn't quite nick it off him again, and Oscar is again running rings around me. But he's offside there, Schürrle. Great. Hazard's on. I think I saw Fabregas in there as well. That's exactly what I didn't need, really. Here's Jones. Sordell. Here's Ings. Ings has found himself a bit of room here. Couldn't quite get the shot away, though. Uh-oh, Ings has gone down, which is exactly what we didn't need as well. Just to compound our woe, really. Here's Jones. Not quite. Mikel. Oh, he's found Costa, who's onside. Good block. Oh, where did that come from? Oscar somehow gets a shot in. He seems to be doing things out of this world at the moment. I don't know how he managed to do that. He just managed to get his head to it. Forced a save out of Heaton in the end. It was a pretty good save in the end as well. Ramirez. Ivanovic. Mikel. Oscar again. They're just passing it around now. And that's a for God's sake. And I think that's Hazard, is it? Yes. Anyway, we're going to have to make some change here. I think Ings is going to have to come off. Not quite sure what the injury is. Jitkovic is coming on. We'll throw Boyd on there as well. And Marnie can go in. I mean, there's no way we're getting back into this, but if we can get a goal or two, maybe. But yeah, this game's just kind of fell to pieces, Ray. I think that third goal kind of killed me. Because if we'd gone in at half-time at 2-1, there's a real possibility that we could have got back into it. But I just think going in at 3-1 down at half-time is just not ideal at all. Here's Mikel, who seems to be showing pace that he's never shown before. Stoker got an equaliser. Keane's done well. Heaton, he's tried to find Jutkovic there, and it might actually be a decent ball. It might have been slightly overhit, though. It is. Again, slightly frustrating in the end. Willian. Diego Costa. Before the tournament started. Oscar. Wide. I think that's the first shot he's missed today, to be honest. And here comes Matic, another substitution they didn't really want. They're just bringing on all their big guns now. I am enjoying this game, though. I mean, it is 4-1, obviously, but I am still enjoying this game. Here's a chance for... Oh, dear. Well, that pretty much sums up the game. I probably shouldn't have gone for a shot from there with Sordell, but... But yeah, I am liking this game. The presentation is great. I mean, the games they've done before this have been relatively evenly matched and they've had a lot of drama, but this one's just kind of been... I know it's always going to be difficult because Chelsea just seem to have a really good team on here and obviously in real life. Here's Jutkovic. Marnie. No. And that's going out for a throw. We haven't really got many options here. That's just... Oh, great. The return of the overhead kick. It wasn't a full overhead kick, but I hated that on the last game. Me. Jones. Keitley. He's done well to get past Ivanovic there, and he's put a decent ball in as well, but it hasn't quite found Sordell in the end. And, oh, God, here's a chance to counter. And Oscar's up with Costa. But Costa just ran back, which is very weird. Shackle trying to get there but couldn't. Late stages of the game. Chelsea are now going to make a change. Oh, crikey, I wasn't expecting Heaton to have it in his feet there, but he did. Oh, free kick. No, apparently not. And here's a chance for them to counter again. And here's Ivanovic and Williams offside, surely. No, apparently not. Oh, great. Oh, it's Oscar again. Oh, he's almost done it again. But that time it's over. And here comes Remy. Thank God he didn't come on earlier because the last thing I needed to hit in my defence was pace. Although Remy's lost it there pretty easily. And here's a chance, actually, if we can whip it over to Sordell. Sordell's won it in the air, but it's gone straight back to Schwarzer. Sadly, we just haven't really been able to create much since we went 3-1 down as well. It's just that third goal, that hat-trick for Oscar was kind of the defining factor in this game. And that is full-time. 4-1 loss, not brilliant. Didn't expect a brilliant start with Burnley against Chelsea. I did call it the impossible, or the mission impossible for a reason. But it could have been a lot better. Just look at that, Oscar. We actually had more chances than them, which is pretty amazing in the end. Just look at that though, their pass accuracy was so much better. So we just have to improve defensively. Arsenal have won, looks like Man United won, amazingly. West Brom won 3-0, what's going on there? Player injured, that's not good. Danny, oh, you got to be kidding me. Oh my god. Well, and on that bombshell, I guess, as I would say in Top Gear, thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye. Queen's Park Rangers.